The theory of general relativity, under which space itself can curve, allows for universe to take one of three forms: flat like a sheet of paper, closed like a sphere, or open like a saddle. This astronomical geometry is no trivial matter. The fate of the cosmos depends on it. Today, we will discuss with you on the topic, what is the shape of the universe? Welcome back to Signature's Life, and you're watching Signature Science. The shape of the universe tells us about its past and its future, whether the universe will expand forever or eventually collapse, and whether it's finite or infinite. All are questions that tie back to its shape. For a matter that bears on such a grand questions, its components are remarkably simple. The ultimate structure of the universe depends on just two factors: its density and its rate of expansion. Roughly 68% of the universe is dark energy and 27% is dark matter. The remainder is normal matter, which accounts for planets, stars, and other bodies. The universe density refers to how much of this matter is packed into a given volume of space. If the universe density is great enough for its gravity to overcome the force of expansion, then the universe will curl into a ball. This is known as the closed model, with positive curvature resembling a sphere. A mind-boggling property of this universe is that it is finite, yet it has no bounds. An intergalactic Ferdinand Magellan could circumnavigate it, traversing space forever without hitting a wall or falling over an edge. On the other hand, if the universe density is low and unable to stop, there's also a Goldilocks scenario for the universe. Cosmological evidence points to the universe density as being just right. The equivalent of around 6 protons per 1.3 cubic yards, and that it expands in every direction without curving positively or negatively. In other words, the universe is flat. Is the universe flat? What does a flat universe mean? This flatness isn't the two-dimensional kind we often encounter in everyday life, but you can envision it with a few analogies. Say you are understanding in one corner of a square room. Walk 10 feet along the wall to the next corner, then turn 90 degrees. Walk another 10 feet and turn 90 degrees again. Do this twice more and you will find yourself back where you started. You have completed a square. This is the standard Euclidean geometry that we all learned in high school. And if you add one more dimension, you will get a flat universe. But conducting this experiment on a positively curved space that representative of a closed universe would create a different outcome. This time, start at Earth's equator. The best clues to the shape of the universe are embedded in the cosmic microwave background, the afterglow of the Big Bang that radiates towards us from every direction. Over the past few decades, scientists have repeatedly measured temperature fluctuations in the cosmic microwave background, essentially performing trigonometry at the largest scale possible, and found almost no curvature at all. A flat universe is a key piece of the standard cosmological model, also known as the lambda cold dark matter. A flat universe is a key piece of the standard cosmological model, also known as the lambda cold dark matter model. Lambda is the Greek letter denoting dark energy. Scientists analyzed the amount of gravitational lensing, how much the light from the CMB has been deflected by the gravity of matter in its path, and found a figure higher than predicted by lambda CDM model. If you remove the assumption of a flat universe, instead of trying to fit the data to the wrong model, he says the deviation disappears. If true, it would overturn decades of astronomical findings. But aside from this data, there isn't the slightest reason to doubt the universe is flat. All other measurements of the CMB, like those by the Atacama Cosmological Telescope in Chile and the Wilkinson Microwave Anisotropy Probe, are consistent with the flatness. Data from the other sources, most notably baryon acoustic oscillations, the imprints left on galaxies from primordial sound waves that occurred after the Big Bang, also suggests flatness. Any theory backed by such overwhelming evidence would leave most scientists skeptical of a single outlier. So at least for now, the universe seems to be a three-dimensional sheet of paper. But just as Melchiorre doesn't insist it's actually closed. Not all scientists insist it's actually flat. That's just how it appears from our point of view. Our observations are, by definition, limited to the observable universe, so we could be missing something. If the universe is curved, though, it must be so colossal that the entire 93 billion light years we can see isn't a large enough portion to reveal the curvature. To take an example from Earth, it could be as if we are standing in a fog, unable to see beyond a small, flat patch of the land, but somewhere out of sight. The horizon proves we live on a sphere. When we say the universe is flat, what we are saying is, of the little bit of the universe we can see, it's consistent with being part of a 3D analog of a flat surface.